It's easy to understand indulging in a fantasy life to take yourself out of a humdrum one. But what about when that fantasy leads to full-blown pretending? Rebecca Jarvis with someone who went from serving French fries to serving up a scam as a French royal.
Once upon a time, the story goes, a little girl grew up in a fairy tale castle on a sprawling estate under towering trees. Her name was as impressive as her home, Genevieve de Montremere. Her childhood, a storybook tale, which begins our story too. Genevieve told the world she'd been born into the Rochechouart family, one of the oldest noble families in France, dating back to the 800s. That's when Charlemagne ruled the Western world and algebra was invented.
The Rochechouart family is one of the famous family of France. It's quite a well-known name.
This is no movie set, no theme park. It's the actual family castle that dates back to the 13th century. Genevieve's resume was equally impressive. Educated at the finest European schools, earning degrees to match her pedigree.
She was an MD and a PhD.
In genetics.
But this story isn't the full story. We turn from France to Fresno, the central California city where Genevieve de Montremere debuts in the early 1990s, her past shrouded in mystery, her future aglow with ambition.
People come from all over the world to start a new life here. It's down to earth, it's not pretentious. There's also a lot of great wealth in kind of a quiet way.
Genevieve, yes, that's her crown, finds her prince when she meets Dr. Michael Weiler, a wealthy pathologist. They marry in 1991, have a little girl, and eventually settle on this lush 15-acre property. Genevieve's prize jewel is her stable of a very expensive and extremely rare breed of horse called Frisians.
She had way more than $1 million worth of horses, easy.
She was a legend amongst the Frisian community. Yeah. She was a geneticist. She was revolutionizing Frisians in America. You were starstruck.
The fact that she would talk to me when she had all these horses and she knew all these things.
Cheryl Skegan and her husband Brian Gwartz both had a lifelong love of horses, and she was eager to chat with the storied Genevieve.
You've described her as the grande dame of the Frisian world.
She exuded tremendous influence.
Did she flaunt her wealth?
Oh, yes. Oh, I don't deal with that. You know, my people deal with that.
Genevieve was famous for her lavish equestrian events and parties.
What were the parties she hosted in her home like?
They were great. She had a beautiful home.
And she would have a huge catered lunch and the tennis courts and a beautiful covered arena. It was just spectacular.
But Genevieve herself was somewhat of a recluse. Like Elsa in Frozen, she rarely came out of her house. Few photos exist of her from this time. She told people she was battling leukemia. And on those rare occasions she was seen, friends say she almost always wore an IV like the one seen here.
What did she tell you about her illness?
That she was dying of leukemia, that she didn't know how long she had. I saw her twice, and I think that's more than most people have.
Over how many years?
Over 10 years.
But behind those stable doors, Genevieve de Montremere was hiding a queen-size secret, a secret that no one in her elite equestrian world could have ever imagined. A mere 30 miles away, we find a man named Gary Hoffman. He knows the face in this picture. Who could forget it? But he says this woman's real name is Genevieve Sanders.
First impression.
Beautiful young lady, very smart. The kind of person that, hey, I'd like to get to know her.
Genevieve Sanders was an all-American girl from Lindsay, California, the daughter of a farmer. She never earned a PhD, and he says she didn't know much French. Gary met her while she was a student at Fresno State University, and he was a teaching assistant.
We got to know each other quite well, just hanging out here, going over to the library next door.
After 2 years, the farmer's daughter and teacher tied the knot. They lived on a tight budget, not quite in a shoe, but in a very modest home. Genevieve took waitressing jobs to keep the cupboard from going bare. But that crown was real, just wasn't from France. Check out her sash in this picture. Yes, Genevieve Sanders was the reigning national raisin queen. Here she is arriving on a 2-week trip to Japan to bolster raisin sales around the Pacific Rim.
She seemed to really enjoy the spotlight.
Yeah, she definitely enjoyed it. She enjoyed that little bit of taste of low-level celebrity she had. She could sort of see how this could be transformed to something else.
Now, at this time, Madonna was queen of the pop charts. That's important because Gary says her transformation from Michigan girl to global superstar inspired his young bride.
Genevieve was very much into that and how a young woman could put on this persona and through all these videos project herself and this character.
The metamorphosis is gradual. Genevieve starts adopting a French accent while she's waiting tables at the Sutter Bar and Grill in Fresno.
What did you think at the time?
I thought it was kind of funny. At home, she would get in front of the mirror and say a few words. I just became to think that it was reinforced, it was rewarded, it was something that people liked to talk to her. She became that much more interesting.
The act worked. It brought bigger tips. And soon, Genevieve is almost going full-time French, even at home.
You had to have realized at some point this is a little kind of crazy behavior.
She was my wife and I loved her.
Eventually, Gary starts looking for an exit out of the land of make-believe. Divorce papers are his ticket.
I'm glad I'm out.
Years later, Genevieve was able to fully realize her phony French dreams when she married the wealthy Dr. Weiler. Her plebeian past has been replaced with the fabricated tale of her noble birth. And it might have worked, but some say she starts to take the Marie Antoinette act too far.
She could hurt you. She could hurt you emotionally, she could hurt you financially, and she was mean. I did something that upset her, and at that point I was supposedly not allowed on her property.
How can you stay angry with a woman dying of leukemia? It was no secret. Genevieve's failing health is even the subject of an article in this National Horse magazine. Then in late 2007, her husband announces that Genevieve succumbs to her illness. But was her end just the beginning?